If you use the Google Assistant on devices like a Nest Mini, a Nest Hub, or a Nest Audio, and you want to start using the Google Assistant on an iPhone, you've come to the right place because in this video, I'm going to walk you through the best ways to use the Google Assistant on an iPhone running iOS 14. Now, the first step in using the Google Assistant on an iPhone is to download the Google Assistant app from the Apple App Store. Just open up the App Store and search for the Google Assistant, and the top result should be the Google Assistant app. Go ahead and download that, and then follow the on-screen instructions to set up the app and link it to your Google account. Once you've got the Google Assistant app downloaded on your phone, you can do things you'd ask a Google Assistant speaker for, and a few additional things you can't do on a speaker, like call or text somebody. With the Google Assistant app, there are three main ways to trigger the assistant. You can tap the mic button at the bottom of the screen, you can say the trigger word to it on your phone with the app open, or you can use the keyboard to type your request to the Google Assistant. Now, you may want to be able to trigger the Google Assistant when your phone screen is off. Unfortunately, by default with iPhones, the only assistant that Apple will let you summon is Siri. Luckily, there are two workarounds for iPhones running iOS 14, and both workarounds involve Siri shortcuts. Now, you can technically just ask Siri to open the Google Assistant, and it will work. However, the Siri shortcuts save you from saying an additional phrase, plus they unlock an additional way to use the Google Assistant on an iPhone, which is why I use them. First, make sure you've downloaded the Shortcuts app on your iPhone. If you don't have the Shortcuts app already, you can download it from the Apple App Store. Just search for Shortcuts, and the app should look like this. Once you have the Shortcuts app downloaded, go back to the Google Assistant app. With the Google Assistant app open, select the Today View icon in the bottom left-hand corner. You should see a pop-up there that will ask you to add the Google Assistant to Siri. Go ahead and click Add to Siri. Next, you can change the trigger phrase you want to use with Siri from the default. So, for example, I'll use Get Google so I don't trigger your Google Assistant devices at home. Next, click Add to Siri. So, let's try it. I'll hold down the power button to summon Siri, or you can use your voice, and then say Get Google. Siri will then ask you what you'd like to ask Google, and then you say whatever you would normally say to the Google Assistant. And Siri Shortcuts will immediately open the Google Assistant app with that question, and then the Google Assistant will respond, which is great for situations like when you're driving. However, do keep in mind you will have to have your phone unlocked for it to be able to open the Google Assistant, and unfortunately, I haven't found a way around this like you have on Android with Smart Lock. Now, if you don't see the pop-up screen, don't worry, there's another way to do this through the Shortcuts app. Open the Shortcuts app and click on the plus sign at the top right corner when you're in the My Shortcuts view. Click Add Action, Apps, then select Assistant, and then select the trigger word for the assistant you want to use. Deselect Show When Run, click Next, and then name your shortcut, and this will be the phrase that you tell Siri to get it to open the Google Assistant app. And then after that, you're done, and now we can test out our shortcut. Here's an example of the shortcut in action. Hey Siri, get Google.
What do you want to ask Google?
Show me my reminders. Now, there's another way to summon the Google Assistant without having to use Siri or opening the Google Assistant app manually, and that's by using the new back tap feature. What this allows you to do is double tap the back of your iPhone to open the Google Assistant app, even if your phone has a case on it, like my iPhone 12 with its Apple Clear Case. To enable this, go to Settings, Accessibility, Touch, then scroll down to Back Tap and select it. Then select either double tap or triple tap, depending on which one you want to use, and then scroll down to Shortcuts and select the Get Google shortcut we created earlier. Now exit Settings and try it for yourself. Just double tap the back of your iPhone and watch the Google Assistant app open from wherever you are on your iPhone. Pretty cool. Well, that's it for my overview of the best ways to use the Google Assistant on an iPhone. I hope you found this video helpful and useful, and if you did and liked it, make sure you hit that thumbs up button below and subscribe to the channel for more how-to videos on Apple, Google, and other tech products. Well, that'll do it for me. For 6 months later, I'm Josh Tedder. Thanks for watching.